future, talk radio will actually educate, inspire, and make you think. The future is now. Topics and music that affect your life from Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com. This is On Air with Tony Sweet, your number one source for all things entertainment, exclusive interviews and guests from TV, film, the Broadway stage, and your favorite musical artists of today. Talking shop is a given, but deep conversation is Tony's specialty. On Air with Tony Sweet starts now, exclusively on UBN Radio.
Okay, we are live here at Sunset Gower Studios in Hollywood on Universal Broadcasting Network. I'm Tony Sweet, and I have a zoo that came to visit me today.
Meow, meow. Meow.
Is that how a giraffe sounds?
This is what a human giraffe sounds
like. Oh, a human giraffe. And I have joining me in studio today a very talented, beautiful giraffe and woman. We have Michelle Ortiz in the house from Mad TV. Michelle, thanks for bringing your pet.
Thank you so much for having me.
Does he have a name?
This is Willow. You have to excuse him. He's very hungover today. We just got done Emmy parties, and we just got done doing a five-year-old's birthday party out in San Fernando. So, you know, Mad TV's not really paying the bills.
Well, thank you, Willow, for joining Michelle.
Yeah.
Okay, so Mad TV, you know, the comeback kids, you know, Mad TV was an amazing TV series, what, in the 80s? Was it 80s?
From 95 to 2007.
It shows you where I'm at.
Yeah. No, I mean, in junior high.
You were barely alive when it first came out.
Five years old. I mean, yeah, no, I grew up on Mad TV. Junior high, Mo Collins, Alex Borstein, Deborah Wilson, Nicole
Deborah
Parker.
Has been here many, many,
really?
Many times, and she's co-hosted with me many times.
Blessings.
Yeah, blessings.
Yes.
Yeah, don't ask her to show your tattoo.
the special one?
Yeah.
The sacred one?
I have to tell you my story about Deborah. I love Deborah. She's one of those that have, there's nothing that can shock her or embarrass her.
Yeah.
And because she has tattoos all over, as you know. And all you got to say, is it everywhere? Oh, yeah. And she just rips her shirt off and boobs hanging out.
A very free spirit, Deborah Wilson. But I will say, aside from that, just working with her, she's amazing.
Genius.
We did a Cosby sketch. Working with her and Ari Spears was so cool. Because, like, you know, once we are on set, like, everything is super professional and stuff. And it's fantastic to watch them, like, improv. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's, I feel like I'm, like, a little baby learning from the professionals, you know.
Well, okay. What I like to do, and you know, we always talk about the shows and talk about the movies and the series that come out. But I want to know. We're going to go back a little bit to where it all started.
Back in time.
Well, you have a good voice too.
Thank you.
So, grew up here in LA,
yes,
right?
All over.
So, tell me about your family. We're funny because you have a great sense of humor, very witty. Tell us about your family because you have to get it from somebody.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, you know what? I mean, I think both of my parents are from Mexico. They're both really funny in Spanish. In English,
like,
their
no.
jokes don't translate. Yeah, no, it's funny. I was actually really nervous to do a talk show in Spanish. I mean, I'm fluent, but I was scared that my humor wouldn't translate.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's an interesting.
So you're funny in English, but you didn't know if it'd translate to
Spanish.
Well,
I just feel like I can express myself better
right.
in English,
right.
but
right.
in Spanish, yeah, I was really scared that like my dark humor wouldn't translate. But it was fine. It was
right.
fine. It was fine. But I would have to say that yeah, both my mom and dad are. They're funny people. They're very cynical and sarcastic.
My father is very good at telling stories,
uh-huh.
jokes, but my mother has the dry sense of humor where she can't tell a story worth crap.
Okay.
So were your family like that at all? Were you kind of the
I feel
mixed?
Like my mom would be, if I was like, hey, mom, like, so why did the chicken cross the road? She'd be like, well, who let the chicken out? Like, you know what I mean?
You're like, you're not supposed to ask that.
No, you don't ask me that. Yeah. And my dad, my dad, I think, he's just like very well read. He's like the type of guy that reads, you know, the LA Times, the New York Times every single day.
Yawn. No, I was kidding.
Yeah. I don't know. I also have my, everyone has a crazy uncle. I have a crazy uncle Oscar.
I am the crazy uncle.
Are you the crazy uncle? Oh my God. Yeah.
All my siblings and their kids. Yeah.
Tony, how sweet are you, Tony?
I'm very sweet. Taste. No, I was kidding.
A little lick. I have a crazy uncle who's really good at telling stories because it's more like his physicality and stuff like that.
Right.
Like
gets into it.
Yeah, totally.
So, okay. So growing up here in LA,
yes.
when did you start realizing that you wanted to be an entertainment or entertainer? Because, you know, most family are going, you're going to be.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, well, coming from Mexican immigrant parents, right. You know, they wanted
I didn't come up here.
What? You want to do what with your life? They wanted me to be a lawyer or a doctor. Mm-hmm. Like that's, and I think that's every like parent's right. dream just because they want to see.
Mine knew.
Yeah.
They're like, no, nope. Do something else.
Yeah. What did your parents want you to be?
They just wanted me to get a job and stick with it for 30 years.
Really?
But I was like, really? You know me, right?
Yeah. I think a lot of parents are like that. They just don't want to see their kids like fail.
Right.
And in something like entertainment, it's, you know, even if you're talented, a lot of times you'll never get that chance. And so it's funny, even, you know, my mom was very supportive growing up just because I always did musical theater. I was always in ballet and, you know, voice lessons.
Oh, ballet.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Oh, yeah. I even studied abroad in Russia and was like taking.
What was her name?
My ballet teacher.
No, you said abroad.
Oh, but on shoot. Sorry, where were we?
No, you about ballet.
You stumped me.
I know, I'm sorry.
You stumped me, Tony.
Wow, Tony stumps the comedian. No.
Hey, I got two tough Tony over here. Yeah.
You're talking about the ballet, and you studied abroad.
Jesus,
and,
space case over here. So I think my mom was always really, really supportive.
Mm-hmm.
And then once I, you know, then I went to college and I graduated, and I was like, okay, now I'm going to start to really audition for, you know, TV and film and really go for it. That's when both of my parents were like, so when are you going to go to law school?
Or like, they set you down.
Do you think maybe you could get a job in the entertainment industry? Maybe, you know, something more realistic. It was always try to do something realistic because,
What was going through your mind? Were you like,
it just wasn't an option. Yeah. It just wasn't an option. Like, it's crazy just like even being on the show now, I just want to be good. Like, I just want to do good work. You know, it's not even about being part of this whole Hollywood scene or whatever, because my goal was never to like be a part. My goal was actually to be on Broadway.
Oh, really?
And I saw that you had Shoshana Bean on the show.
I love Shoshana.
Oh my God, she. I think
that girl can sing the phone book.
Look, I have chills just talking about her. That's how much I love she. I think she was my favorite Elphaba in Wicked.
Yeah, oh, for me too. Because her voice is.
It's
a lot of the people from Broadway are going to hate me. What's the original one?
Idina Menzel.
I'm not a big fan of hers.
I did an impression of her show. Yeah.
Singing wise?
Yeah, both.
Look
yeah.
At you. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah. Shoshana's voice is just so raw.
Yeah.
And then her belts are so. Oh my God, they're amazing. She's so good. She's amazing.
Yeah, I agree. Shoshana is amazing. And, you know, she's been on my show a few times. And if I ever have a concert, she's the one I'm going to call because I know that she is on point every single time. When she goes on stage, that is her job.
And I think that's hard to, you know, do musical theater and be like doing like, you know, musical theater belting and then be able to sing like In the House of Love, like her R&B. Hi. her like R&B pop stuff.
It's hard for like a lot of Broadway people to switch to just top 40 sounds.
Totally. And then all like, you know, even classical opera singers, like they can never get rid of that operatic vibrato.
Right.
You
know? Yeah. Okay. So you wanted to do Broadway. So did you do a lot of theater here or did you go travel around with any traveling?
Well, actually, this is a little fun fact.
All right.
I actually auditioned for Hamilton yesterday.
Yesterday?
Yeah, fingers crossed. Yeah, for Eliza.
Wow.
We'll see.
How did that come about? I mean, did my agent
yeah.
call and say,
I actually sent a self-tape like 5 months ago to play Peggy. But then, I don't know, I guess they're here in LA and my agent got me the audition for Eliza. Yeah.
That's exciting. I mean, that's the number one Broadway show right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I I love Broadway. I love musical theater.
Are you a singer?
I used to sing.
Oh, okay.
I was on a reality show in 2008 in Nashville.
Oh, really? Yeah, Nashville. I should have done more research on you. I know. I'm going to stalk you after this.
But what's funny is now I don't sing. I just talk. So it's
great speaking voice.
Why, thank you very much.
Listen to this voice, guys.
So where are we gonna know? So wow, I'm learning all kinds of stuff about you. And this is great because I think for the people that are listening and saying, should I be in this industry? You have a well diverse range of what you can do. Because a lot of people think I just want to do movies or
I want to do it all. My plan, my real plan was after graduating college, I was like, I'm just going to go to Broadway. I'm just going to do it. But then I realized that New York was too expensive. They're even casting TV stars to be than they do just, no names.
I wish they wouldn't have done that. But.
I know, but they need to fill the seats. People aren't really going to theater that much nowadays. However, in Europe, oh my God, Russia, people go to the theater as much as they do go see a movie. It's amazing. Yeah. But so my plan was, okay, well, I'm not going to do New York. I'll stay here because then I got with my manager and my agent or whatever. And I was like, I'll just take over TV, and then I'll go to Broadway.
Good for you. That's a plan.
Reverse.
That is a plan. Yeah. So, like I said, your wit and you're funny, and I've interviewed a lot of comedians, and like I said, you can tell me if I'm going too far, but there's always something that underlying sadness about comedians. I don't know if it's more stand-up. Maybe it's more stand-up that...
Do we want to talk about my depression right
now?
Yes,
I do. No, I'm kidding. No, I'm not. I'm just saying. But besides you having your family being funny, do you agree that there's a lot of comedians out there that it's more the attention of the attention to fulfill the sadness? Or I'm not talking about you.
No,
in
just
general.
In general.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tony. That's a great question.
Well, yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I think any actor, comedian, artist in general. Mm-hmm. I feel like nothing's ever good enough mm-hmm. for us, or at least I mean for myself. Even booking Mad TV was a dream come true.
Right.
But now I'm like, okay, what's the next step? Like, how are we gonna get to the next level? Like, mm-hmm. how can I, create better performances, better characters? How can I tell stories that are meaningful and really like reach out to audiences? And I really want to do work that says something. Mm-hmm. But nothing's ever, like for the Hamilton audition yesterday, I'm like, oh my God, I sucked. Like, oh my God, I was so terrible. I should have belted more on that last note. Like,
Right.
And then my agent called and they're like, no, for feedback. And they're like, no, they said you did great. Not sure about a callback yet, but we'll see how it goes. Mm. So it went fine. But for me, I think I failed,
But do you ever walk out going, damn it, I hit that. I mean, that was amazing.
Once in a blue moon. For Mad TV, actually.
Really?
After I was, in the first audition for Mad TV, I was so nervous. Because there was a lot of, YouTube and Vine stars that they were auditioning for the... Oh, yeah. For the, first audition. And it was one of those audition rooms where you can hear everything. So you can hear everyone's audition. You can hear if they're laughing.
That would make me nervous.
It's the worst. So then I go in. And I think I did Dora the Explorer first. And they immediately started laughing. So I was like, oh, I got this. And then, won them over by the end of it. And then, got a call back and the rest is history.
How do you do that, though? Because I've always, every time my upper lip starts sweating when I start hearing and talking about improv.
Oh, okay.
Because you seem to be very, very good at that. No? Maybe you that you can.
No,
I don't know.
I can improv. Do I like to improv? No. But I will if I have to. What I mean?
But you have those people like Deborah.
Oh,
she loves that stuff.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's like, I don't, that would make me nervous.
You know what makes me nervous about improv? I'm always scared I'm going to say something like politically incorrect and I'm going to offend someone or I don't know.
But isn't that in improv, though, that no matter even what you say, the other person's supposed to not say no?
Yes, and. Yeah, I guess, but I don't know. I feel like my humor is a little more raunchy, a little darker, a little more PG-13. No, I'm just kidding.
No. We need
rated
we need
X.
R. Yes,
no,
yes.
No.
Show some boobs.
Yeah.
No, Deborah. That's okay.
You don't want to see this goddess?
I've seen enough with her. That was enough for a year.
That's enough for all of us.
Yes. So improv, was that something that you had went to school for before? Or did you start taking it more when you found out you were going to get it at TV?
Well, I had always done like improv in like high school and college. Just because as an actor, you should be able to improvise. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, even on script, you know, like an episodic, I don't know, a drama or something where you do have a script that's like line by line. Mm-hmm. A lot of times the best stuff comes from improvising. So I feel like all actors should be able to improv. But no, I just did high school and college. And then I think I did one class at UCB just to put on my resume because casting director was like, oh, she went to UCB. She must be great. But yeah, no. I'd never done sketch comedy before.
Really?
Yeah.
None.
The first time I did was in the CBS Diversity Showcase, which was just in January of this year.
I was looking, doing some research. I was looking through your resume here that you were on Nickelodeon's
Nicky, Ricky, Dicky, and Dawn.
So yeah. was that one of your first big
Nicky, Ricky,
roles?
Yeah, that was like my first like, oh, praise the Lord, I can do this. Like,
oh, really? Yeah. So you're okay. Your validation.
Oh, for sure. I mean, before that, I just done a lot of commercials and most.
Well, those can make pretty good money too.
Oh, for sure, for sure. But it does feel like you're selling your soul a little bit. Okay. You know, and you know, most of the commercials that I booked, I'd book them in Spanish and English. So I like Spanish
That's
market.
Smart.
Hey,
I couldn't do that.
Yeah. Bilingual. So when I booked Nicky, Ricky, Dicky, Dawn, it was a one-line co-star. Then once I got to set, after like the producer run through or the network run through, they started giving me more lines. And so by the end of that episode, I had like 5 lines, which sounds very small. But then it turned into a recurring character. So I've done 3 episodes, and hopefully they'll bring me back.
Wow!
Yeah.
That I mean, and then you went to you were at CBS Life in Pieces. I don't know what that one is because I don't watch.
Pieces,
tell me that.
It's Zoe Lister-Jones, Colin Hanks.
Oh yeah, yeah. Okay, okay.
Diane Wiest.
Yeah, I don't know.
Josh Brolin's dad, James Brolin.
James Brolin.
James Brolin. Yeah. That was a baby co-star as well. But I booked. That was this year. I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
look, so Nicola, you can't even, you're doing so much, you can't remember.
No, you know what? It's this year's been crazy.
Well,
in a very good way.
And I think, you know, when you get opportunities like this, it does open doors
yes.
for people, you know, exposure to see
yes.
see you in action and then opportunities for new projects.
Definitely. I don't think I would have gotten the Mad TV audition if it weren't for the CBS Comedy Showcase.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Look at you.
Yeah. No, I definitely recognize that.
Well, I wanna play listen, this is from Mad TV, and I think this is the first episode, is that correct? When I watched it, I just about peed. So growing up in, you know, the Midwest and, you know, the Bible Belt,
yep.
I was just ready. I was like, well, she gonna pray? I'm like, okay.
Good old little Christian boy.
So I want you guys to watch this and we'll be right back after this.
1 minute to places. 1 minute.
Hey, thanks, Bruce. Guys, the live show, we're here.
Oh, my God. I am fully turnt, y'all. Hey. Hey, guys. I know this might be cheesy, but before going on stage, I like to do a quick group prayer with my cast. Would you guys be down?
That's not really.
Okay, why not?
Sure.
Awesome. You guys are the best. Okay, let's do it. Okay. Oh, Lord, we offer these words of prayer to you.
Is this from Corinthians?
Almighty Lord Satan, we cast ourselves into thine arms and place ourselves under thine all-powerful protection.
You know, we should probably get to places.
Unleash vengeance upon those who seek our destruction and render them powerless and devastated.
This we ask in your name, Almighty Lord Satan. Who liveth and reigneth forevermore? Ave Satanos!
Great! Thanks, guys!
Let's do it!
Oh, and if you guys get nosebleeds, don't freak out. It's a good thing. That just means the big guy's watching over you.
Oh. What does that even mean?
Oh my God, you are hilarious. I love you.
Thank you.
So Did you help create these scenes for yourself, or does do you?
That actually was my idea. They had written a backstage sketch where we're all like Facebook Live and tweeting and like Snapchat, and I asked them if there was any chance they had me just like Facebook Live like or whatever, and so I asked them, I was like, is there any chance like when you get to my part I'm just doing like some crazy ritual in like my dressing room or something, like sacrificing a goat or something like that. And luckily the writer John Barinholtz was like, oh my god, I love that, and they ended up writing a whole sketch for it. So
that's hilarious.
Yeah.
All right. So tell me about your mom and dad when they saw that.
Oh, they loved it.
Oh, did they?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, they loved it.
You know, because I know a lot of the
Mexican Catholics.
Yeah. They can get pretty.
I mean, we grew up Catholic, but we're not religious.
Oh, okay. Yes. All right. That makes a difference, because yes. I've met a few. They'd probably be coming down to the studio going, holy water.
I know, right? Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo. I'm not sure if it's on YouTube or on Facebook, but there's some comments that are like, I was offended. Like, how could they start the episode with something, worshiping the devil?
Like, I mean, it's comedy, people. I mean, come on. What do you expect? So, when you got the call that says you got the part, what ran through your mind at that point?
Manager, agent. Every time your manager and agent are on the same call, that's like when you know you booked something. So, you know, they go like, you got it. And I just started laughing. I was like, I just started laughing. And my manager,
they're like, are you okay?
Yeah, yeah. He was like, are you okay? I was like, yeah. Just kept laughing maniacally, and I think my manager was like, well, congratulations, we'll call you back later. And then later he was like, you sounded like you were tripping on mushrooms or something. You were like on the
let her
best
come down
drug.
Yeah. Yeah, let her come down. Yeah. We'll call her back.
It's my drug. Yeah.
Wow. And so,
and then I called my mom and cried, and, you know, yeah,
of
yeah,
course,
yeah.
I would do the same thing.
Oh yeah.
So when you got the call that you got the part, how fast was it that you started shooting? Did you have some time to prepare? Or?
No, it was probably like, I want to say it was like a week or two right after.
Wow.
Maybe?
Because I've heard like people that work for Tyler Perry, they're like, you got the job. All right, go get your stuff. You're in 2 hours, your plane leaves. You're
totally,
that type of thing. You're
totally.
Like, oh, crap.
What the hell? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, that's kind of how Life in Pieces and Nicky Ricky Dicky Don were.
Really?
It was like kind of like found out on Friday, started shooting on Monday.
Oh my God. That would... Yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't
do
it.
Quick turnaround.
that would just drive me crazy. I'd be like, can I have like a couple weeks to prepare?
Yeah, please, to memorize? Yeah. 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 But I guess that's the name of the game.
So tell us about the time when you guys, all the cast, finally come together for the first time. Did you know anybody?
The only person I knew was Jeremy D. Howard, because we did the CBS showcase together.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And so the first time I met everybody was at like a photo shoot for the promo, which was kind of like, it kind of sucked it didn't suck, but it was weird because it was like the first time we're all meeting and we like have to take a photo where we're like, we're
like,
besties.
Yeah, yeah, like,
we've known each other for years.
Like, God,
we've been doing the
I'm
show. Yeah, yeah, you're right. God. Amir K's B.O. Jesus.
Right, right.
Just kidding.
Yeah, shh. Didn't know. So Matt took the pictures. And then what was the process like? Who was the first people that you actually had to work with? Because, you know, there's always skits uh-huh. and scenes. So what was your first?
I think one of the first ones, which is like one of the first ones in the first episode, was the Trulywed Game, where I play Melania Trump and Piot does an amazing Donald Trump. And we were against Will Sasso as Bill Clinton and Nicole Sullivan as Hillary Clinton.
Miss Hillary.
Oh, my God. Thanks. That was a surreal experience. Because that was also our first live taping, that was the first sketch of the night. And so that was, I was on cloud nine.
I bet. And where's this shot at? Where's the film?
The studio? Oh, my God. Right down the street at Hollywood Center Studios.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
5 minutes from my house. Dream job.
Oh, my. Hell, yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So I'm sure being in front of a live studio audience, right?
Yeah. It's a mix. It's a mix of digital and live. Yeah, 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 yeah.
But there's nothing like being in front of a live audience to get that instant gratification of applause.
Totally.
And like you said, people that actually laugh or not laugh, and that's when they add stuff in.
Well, it's great because like
you're not laughing. Turn it on.
Laugh track. Insert laugh track. Well, it's great, yeah, because you feed. There's this energy in the room mm-hmm. that you feed off of, and that's better than any heroin injection.
I'm sure it is. And then also, you're in like every cast that replaces, you know, like Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
What was it? What was from criticism to compliments of saying, you're not the original cast?
Yeah.
I mean, did you get that on both sides?
Oh, definitely. I mean, here's the thing. I don't know. I'm sure a lot of people are like this. I love reading the hater, hater comments, because it feeds me. So then I'm like, oh, I'll show you wrong. I'll prove it to you.
Right.
I need that gratification.
I know. I'm gonna make you love me.
Yeah. Exactly. So I say I embrace the haters.
Yeah.
But there's also been a lot of people commenting saying that they love our original characters. They want to see more original characters.
And that's good. Cool. I mean,
yeah,
definitely.
That's always great.
And what people are responding to for you, for your, which character?
Mine is definitely the Dora the Explorer. My rated R version of Dora the Explorer.
The Streetwalker. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. No, really though. Skid Row. And then next week's our last episode. Mm-hmm. I do a J-Lo impression.
Oh my God.
And I do some.
Can you dance like her?
I did do a little dance.
Hey.
I did. Yes.
All right.
Tuesday nights, 9:00 next week, guys. CW. I think I do some like Texas cheerleader, like former Dallas Cowboys cheerleader,
right,
who's just like a hot mess. But I'm definitely known more for the Dora.
So when you started seeing some of the alum cast.
Oh my God, yeah.
What was it like when you see them walk in or meet them for the first time? And
I'm usually never like starstruck, but
right,
I think I definitely embarrassed myself a little bit. I fangirled out with Will Sasso and Mo Collins.
Oh, I love you.
Oh my God, Mo, I could cry right now. Working with Mo was amazing. And during the live taping, it's the first time I've ever cracked on camera. Or like even in my life, I've always been like, I'm a classically trained actor. I'm so serious. I take this, you know? And she was doing a character called Carol Fitty, this like crazy cat lady. And I was doing Lupe, baby Joker from Whittier, California. I was doing this like ghetto chola. And she would like look me dead in the eye and just like make me crack. Because she was doing this like, her father was a turtle. And Mo turns completely different. Her facial expressions,
yeah,
she completely morphs into the character. And so that was really special. That's my special moment.
Yeah, I you know, there's a lot of people that I've interviewed, probably about 1,200-1,300 people in 9 years. And I have to say, there are a few people that I've met that, oh my God, you freak out because you've grew up with them.
You know what it is too? I don't know. Like when you meet me, or like when you meet any comedian or actor, you kind of expect them to put it on,
right,
like, you know,
right,
and, you know, do an impression. But for the most part, I'm pretty grounded.
Seem like it.
Yeah, right? Okay.
Yeah, you seem like it. you didn't see her off air, though.
Insert fart noise.
Oh, I have one over here. No,
oh, scared. Give me. So when I met Mo, it was so refreshing to see that she was just like super grounded, super sincere, mm-hmm, just like a good person. Like she was amazing. And then to see her perform with us and then be like, okay guys, let's just improv, like let's do this.
Wow.
Because I feel like when the all-stars came, they were definitely allowed to play more than we were,
right
so
well, they, I guess they earned the stripes.
It was exactly so it was a treat.
So Mad TV's on, you're doing great, people love it. So what has it inspired you to even do more of? I mean, because you knew you wanted to act, you knew you wanted to be in entertainment, but what has it kind of inspired you to even do something. Write, produce?
Yeah, definitely write. It's funny because right before Mad TV, I was like so suicidal. I was like, crap, like I'm getting all this good feedback. Like I was doing Nickelodeon,
right,
but you know, that's only every so often.
Right.
And auditioning is just so awful.
Are you a good auditioner?
I think now I am.
Yeah,
now I am. But I mean, we all still get nervous.
Right.
I'm back to audition. I'm on a show, but I'm still back to auditioning
right
now. So
right,
it's not all glitz and glamour. But it has, before Mad TV started, I was like, crap, I'm going to have to write my own web series and like start producing my own content.
And that's a good thing about today than 20 years ago. You
exactly,
could do that.
Exactly. So yeah, no, it's definitely inspired me to write. I wish I could have my own female version of like the Eric Andre show on Adult Swim. I'm obsessed with him.
Why don't you? What's stopping you? Maybe
I will.
See? There you go.
There you go.
I always say nothing's stopping you but
Too Tough Tony.
That's right.
Giving Michelle Ortiz inspiration.
They're great. So working
that,
with... Oh, go ahead.
And I'm sorry to interrupt you.
I'm
watching Vice Principals right now, and Danny McBride is like my hero.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I would kill to work with him.
I was going
to
ask you, is there other people that, you, besides the original alum of Mad TV, who else would you like to work with?
Danny McBride, for sure. Walton Goggins, from they're on Vice Principals. Mm-hmm. They're amazing. Eric Andre. I'm trying to think, are there any like females that I'd like to work with? Yeah, I think I'm just saying those because those are the shows that I'm like obsessing over right now. But yeah.
Is there anybody that that you would love to portray, you know, if it was a biography of somebody? Who would that be?
Ooh, great question. Well, if they ever turn Wicked or like In the Heights into a movie musical, like I will murder someone to be in it. That's how serious I'm in. But I don't know, Selma Hayek already did a Frida Kahlo movie.
Right, that was a great movie.
Yeah, really great. I think she like produced it.
I'm sure she did. Yeah. I don't know if she did. I'm sure she did.
Yeah, I think something like that. I'm trying to think of. I've always wanted, I'm really jealous of like Natalie Portman in Black Swan. I would love to do like some kind of.
You know, I have never seen that movie.
Oh, it's great. It's Darren Aronofsky. Amazing.
Yeah. I've always said, oh, I'll watch it when it comes out on video on demand. Yeah. I just never have.
And it's great.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll have to watch it.
That was his last good one. Because then it was, what did he do? Noah's Ark.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
That was.
I couldn't finish it.
I've watched it.
Yeah.
But I think I was just sitting there because I was like, I don't feel like turning it. Yeah. I guess I'll
spend 2 hours of my life watching.
My life is boring, so might as well watch a boring movie.
I love it.
Yeah. So would you rather do a comedy or would you rather have like a Oscar worthy?
Oh. I want to go. I want to win a Tony. I
want
to. Oh, win
you want
an
it all.
Oscar. I want it all. Yeah,
Golden Globe. Emmy,
everything.
All
everything.
That stuff.
Everything. No, honestly, I don't care about awards. I love doing comedy, because it's light on the soul. But I would love to do a drama.
The best example of somebody that was now that he's passed away, Robin Williams. That when he, you know, going from being a stand-up comic and funny as hell to actually being able to be an amazing actor.
Did you ever see
amazing?
What's that one where he plays the creepy photo?
Yeah. Oh, that was.
He was so fucking. He was so good.
You
Sorry.
Can say that. Don't worry. We're not FCC regulating.
Oh
so.
My God. Yeah. What else? He's amazing. I think Steve Carell.
He's
also
done well. Like, he's done well. But, but Robin, for me, was the one that... It was like Cher being a singer.
Do you believe in love after love?
All right, now.
Okay.
If I could do Sonny, I would challenge you to a...
Come on now.
I know.
Too Tough Tony over here.
I can't do it. I can't do it. But, you know, Cher was like that. As amazing singer, legend in her own time, and then became a great actress.
Yeah.
And it's really hard for some of those people, comedian, to become a very serious actor or actress. And he happened to be one that I think was perfect.
No, I agree. I agree.
But is that something you feel like, you know, I want to take roles that are not always funny, but something that that will challenge you?
100%. Yeah, that's the name of the game. Anything that's, I'm willing to accept any challenge. It's funny, there's like, well, I kind of have this new goal right now about I've already started. I'm making like original music for myself.
You write music?
Yeah. Well, kind of.
Do you play instrument too?
I can play chords on a guitar, but not like fully. So I'm actually strumming. Working with his fingers. Come on now. So I'm actually working on writing my own original music because I feel like the music that you hear on the radio today, not only is it, I don't like the message it sends to like little girls that are dancing to Sex in the Air and na 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 na. Like, I feel like everything is so sexualized, and pop music has killed a lot of children's souls. And I feel like a lot of little girls, like the only artists that are really like making music that is not about sex Adele. And love. Well, no, Adele's music is still about love, but like Sia.
Oh, right.
You know?
I love Sia.
Yeah, she's great. And I actually loved Sia before she blew up in high school with her like first album, because she's a really great writer. She doesn't necessarily write about sexual tension and body parts.
Yeah, she's pretty empowerment.
Yeah, like, exactly. Yeah. So recently I've been really inspired to write.
For you? No, English, Spanish, or both?
I'm actually working on a song where I'm mixing Spanish and English. Yeah,
I think that's a smart
idea. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
It'll reach a wider audience.
Now, have you ever had anything played on the radio? Or
I'm still working on
it. So you've never recorded anything?
No, I mean I'm working on stuff right now. Oh, okay. So maybe you'll have me back on in a couple months.
I would love that. Yeah. And I just think it's funny. Definitely you have a voice. You've known you've had a voice, and you want to do musical theater. I'm like, I'm surprised you have not recorded anything.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny. I just, you know, my goal, like I said, was always, you know, Broadway or whatever.
Right.
But I enjoy singing. You know, I love singing classical. I love singing, you know, hip-hop and R&B. Mm-hmm. I love belting. I love singing pop. Like, I love it all. I want to do it all. I want to do it all.
Are you a soprano or?
Mezzo-soprano. Belter.
Squeeze me.
Yeah.
Well, I adore you. I think you're just talented,
Tony.
Amazing. You're beautiful. You're funny.
Thank you.
And you bring pets to visit me.
Yep.
And I know.
Willow.
Do you have other animals at home or?
No, it's just, well, you know, I have a fat Carl. He's a Russian blue tabby cat.
Oh, really?
Hey, Carl.
Is he blind
right
or? Huh? Somebody the other day is like, oh, I have a blind cat and you want to hear it? And I'm like, what do you mean you want to hear it? And they get their phone out and it's like, meow. I was like, oh my God. You like,
no, I just have a fat cat.
Well, I adore you, and will you come back and see me, please?
100%. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, please. I love it. All right, Michelle Ortiz, Matt TV, Tuesdays
on
CW. I love it. All right, we're going to be back here in just a minute. We have more to talk about. We're going to have Kurt come in, and we're going to play some YouTube videos just for you guys. This is On Air with Tony Sweet.
Woo!
On Universal Broadcasting Network.
Hey, now.
Be right back.
with On Air with Tony Sweet, only on Universal Broadcasting Network.
Oh, we're back. Kurt.
Thanks.
I have Kurt Carlson with me today.
Blowing out my ears there. Thanks. I appreciate that.
I love to scare Kurt. Well, let me fix Kurt's camera because our guest was a little shorter. So, well, thank you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed Michelle. She is amazing. Devin Wilder. Hi, Devin. How you doing? Devlin. Yeah, Devlin. Devlin. Devlin.
Sure.
Anyway, we'll get back to me. All right, so Kurt and I are going to look up YouTube. We love to always play on YouTube here at UPN Radio. We have nothing else to do.
I just want to let you know that I'm here to promote my video of of me dancing.
Let's show that.
Thank you for that, by the way, Tony.
Let's show it.
Yeah, sure.
let's show Kurt. So yesterday here at work, Kurt, he's always trying to get in the spotlight. Always.
Oh yeah, because you know I love to be behind the camera.
And so we were playing.
We were trying to set up the green screen, I believe. Which
I think that's what it was.
You completely screwed me up on because, yeah.
But Kurt loves to dance, and so I thought, Kurt, why don't you just get in front of the green screen and dance for me? And this is what.
And again, I thought we were setting the green screen up, not you making me look like a fool on Facebook Live.
So I put on Facebook Live, it says, Kurt doesn't know I'm filming this. But it was funny. I had a good time.
It's funny for you.
But you're dancing. Who's the women behind you? Did your wife get mad at you for that?
Well, you know, what she doesn't know.
All right. Yeah. This is like Vegas.
Yeah, exactly.
What happens at work stays at work.
Trust me, I don't want her to know what happens here at work. Right.
Sometimes you don't. Sometimes you don't. But Kurt's good at finding videos on YouTube. So what should we look up today?
Well, there's always funny cat videos you can look up.
Cat videos. All right, let's look up and see what funny cat videos we can find. So let's see. Funny cat videos. So people that are listening to us, and by the way, congratulations to On Air with Tony Sweet. We got approved by iHeartRadio. Yes. So now our podcast can be listened to on iHeartRadio every week. All of our shows are there, and we hope you guys enjoy. And tell us again who maybe you want to have on the show. We'd love to hear other, you know, some actors, comedians, whatever. We'll find out. But so here it says a funny I got to get rid of the commercial. I hate these damn commercials.
Why don't you get YouTube Red already?
Bread?
Red.
What's that?
It's where you pay where you don't have to get commercials for YouTube anymore.
Oh, okay. Well,
Or you can go to RedTube.
Isn't that a porn site? Kurt, you're married. What do you know about a porn site? And you're like, well, how do you know?
Well, I'm just saying you could go there.
Yeah, okay. All right, so this is a kitty cat. Oh, I think a kitty cat just burned him. Is he trying to... What is he doing to those poor cats?
I love it when the cats fall into water.
So people are watching. There is a bath full of water with a poor cat. And there was like a inner tube in it, and it jumps right in the middle and falls
into the
water.
Yeah, and it goes right in. They always are so... You can't go wrong with cat videos. If you're feeling down...
Right. And so...
You can watch cat videos.
These poor cats. Cats are the funniest thing. Even though I'm more of a dog person than I am a cat.
Oh, I love dogs.
But same here. Cats can be hilarious when they come... Because they're so curious about everything.
Yeah, they have such a personality to them. Yeah. So
I always said... I always said cats remind... What the hell was that? Oh, I thought that was a dog. Oh, the cat bit on the lip.
Yeah.
But I always said cats remind me of gay men. Their personalities. They're always curious. They're always getting in trouble. But anyway, what's another one we can pull up? Okay, we got cat videos. What else?
Oh, I'm checking my search history.
You do
now.
That.
You know, I'm gonna find you something that's pretty funny.
And I'll keep you guys going. So. So what we're going to do is, starting next week, we have, I'm trying to get some a co-host in. Carla has been jury duty. Carla has been working. And I want to get some new co-host in to keep me company and keep us going. But we want to, go ahead.
I found one.
All right, tell me.
Type it in, this name right here.
I can't see it.
Oh, because you're blind, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Oh, my God. Okay.
It should be that first one there.
All right. Keep it down.
Yeah, that first one there.
This one?
He is now playing for that team that he lit up.
What the
hell? I'm talking about the new New Orleans Saints quarterback, Jim Everett.
So I saw this. All right,
that was then, and this is now. He's now a member of the Saints. Jim, good to have you on the show.
Good to be here, Jim. Thank you.
Is something going to get in a fight or something?
You know, you've been telling me that for about the last 5 years.
So this guy here,
he gets called
a different name every time he goes on this.
We came back and won.
Is this when he throws the table over?
Let's see, but this was back in 1989.
Right,
so you may have even been Jim Everett back there, but somewhere along the way, Jim, you ceased being Jim and you became Chris.
Well, let me tell you a little secret. That, you know, we're sitting here right now, and if you guys want to take a station break, you can. But if you call me Chris Everett to my face one more time...
I already did it twice.
You call one more time, we better take a station break.
Well, it's a five-minute segment. Our five-segment show. We got a long way to go.
We
got a long way to go.
It should be interesting.
We'll get a couple segments out
of here. Well, it's good to be here with you, though.
Well, it's good to see you, too.
You've been talking like this behind my back for a long time.
But now I said it right here.
Right.
I love how he keeps a smile on his face.
I think that you probably won't say it again.
I bet I do.
Okay.
Chris?
Come on. I love how he just pushes him down.
I think that you probably won't say it.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah, that was it. They cut the audio out there at the end there, but he started screaming the other guy, saying, get him off me, get him off me.
Oh, God. Why would you even do that when you sat there, you provoked him?
He's for the NFL, too.
Was he still?
No, I don't know if he is still now, but I mean, when that video was recorded, he was in the NFL.
Yeah, you can tell. Kurt and I watch sports a lot. I didn't understand because it's like, okay,
if
you want him to get off, why would you even provoke him? Like, for ratings, though. Look, we're still talking about it, so.
Well, I guess who he was referring to him as Chris was, I guess, a female tennis player. So it was kind of like calling him a girl.
Chris Everett.
He kept saying that he's a woman, which is demeaning to him. So
I get it. Okay,
That's the behind the scenes on that one.
Okay. Did you watch the Emmys?
No, I was recuperating from. Did you watch the Emmys?
No. Kurt actually went to Disney World.
Yeah, I was
for a week.
You
left me, and you were never to go on vacation ever again. Okay. He left me here by myself, all alone.
I wanted to ask you if it was okay next month, if I could.
No, 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 you're not. You're not going anywhere.
Well, so Stacy and I are going to go out to
Stacy can go. She can go. You can't.
We're going to be leaving for the holidays, all of them.
Okay, so Stacy and I are going to go on holiday, and you're staying here. You're never doing that again. So anyway, all right. Well, it's time for us to get out of here anyway. So, but we want to thank Michelle Ortiz for joining us today. Check her out on CW's Mad TV. Have you seen it? The new Mad TV?
I have not, but it looks really interesting.
She's funny. She is funny. Very sweet. I love the giraffe costume.
Yeah, I saw it. I was like, who is that?
Right. You should wear that to work every day.
I mean, if you want me to,
I think I
might get
cool.
A lawsuit out of
get
it.
Get an anteater. Just a big old nose.
That's what something you want.
I don't get it. All right, we're out of here.
Thank you so much, Chris.
You call me Chris one more time, and I don't think you're going to call me. All right, we're out of here on Amber Tony Sweet, right here on Universal Broadcasting from Sunset Gower Studios in Hollywood. See you guys next week. Bye-bye now.
Bye, Chris.
This has been On Air with Tony Sweet. Don't worry, there's more online. Search On Air with Tony Sweet on iTunes for past shows and exclusive behind-the-scenes content. On Air with Tony Sweet every Wednesday and Friday from 4 to 6 p.m. Pacific, right here on UBNRadio.com.